Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds. Last time, we finished off the first big chunk of side questing here in the game, and trust me, there's gonna be a whole lot more, as you can probably tell with the pinpoint markers that you can see spread out across Hyrule on the bottom screen. We'll be doing that next time. Well, beginning that. I don't know if we'll be able to do that all next time. But that's not what this episode is about. This time, we're going to be heading to the second dungeon of the game. And it is actually... And, blah, if I can speak. It is actually a new dungeon to this game. Not like A Link to the Past. And I want to destroy this peg. Thank you. So, let us whip up the Irene Bell. And let us head down to the House of Gales. Alright, we have arrived at the House of Gales, as you see. We need the Tornado Rod for this, and the Tornado Rod, as you saw earlier, is already equipped to the X button. So, how about we use it right now? And as you see in the top left corner of Under the Tiles, there is a button, and that button will open the door to the entrance of the House of Gales. So without any further ado, let us head inside. Alright, so, the new dungeon with the new item in this game. I should rephrase that a little better. I'm sad that the Desert Palace isn't the second dungeon like A Link to the Past, but I'm very, very excited that they did change it up a bit to where we have a new dungeon, the House of Gales, and plus it helps incorporate the new items, so it's pretty cool. Anyways, let's see. This is the main gimmick here, this big fan. We'll be seeing that a lot throughout here. Oh, and hey, there's a lantern puzzle, so let's exchange the hammer for the lamp, and that allows a treasure chest to appear. And inside is a red rupee worth 20. Excellent. Okay, so... Keese, we can just ignore you. Thank you for the rupees there. Alright. I never mentioned this, but it's so cool how the rupees, and even hearts, can be painted on in the walls with your merge ability. It is really, really neat. What we needed to do was come down here, hit the switch, allowing that wall to disperse, allowing us to use the merge ability along here, getting a rupee. And also, as you see, we have the lip, we have the lamp equipped, and it actually appears in the merge painting. It's a really, really neat detail that the developers didn't really need to do, but still, it's really, really nice to see. Anyway, we have these enemies here. Bubbles, I think they're called? Bubbles or fairies, one of those. And right here, as you see, hearts in the drawings, which is really cool. Like I said, I like it very much. Okay, let's get this guy. Okay. And there we go! Wow, we were right next to the treasure chest. Unfortunately, we couldn't spawn it on top of our body. That is possible, and I actually did it in my practice run of this dungeon, but... I digress, we can't do it right now. Alright, we got a small key in that treasure chest, though, so... Now we can make our way over here, and we can unlock this door! Okay, so now we have merge puzzles! If you didn't do side questing like I did, if you're playing along with me or something like that, if you didn't do side questing like I did, then this will be the first time you use your merge ability extensively. So that's pretty cool. Right here is the compass. Now we can see the treasure chest and locked doors. There's actually a treasure chest all the way on the southwestern corner here in this room. So that's pretty neat. Okay, let's grab these here. Let's wait for this to come back. There we go. All right, got it. There's a better look at the lamp being equipped. It's so... I love the detail of this game. It's so nice. These guys that seem to spark no matter what... What the hell did I just get hit? Okay. I just got hit there. I don't know. I went too early. Can I... Okay, I still made it. All right. Just destroy you. Hit this button. That's gonna blow the wind over on the other side of the room. But we were headed over here, so it's not like it really mattered. And these guys right here, when he splits in two, do they, is it just me or do they always spark? It might be just me, but every time I destroy one of those enemies and they split in two, it seems like they always spark, those two little ones. See? Look, they're like always sparking. What is up with that? And what is up with that keys hitting me? I don't appreciate it. We can head over this way. Into this room here. Ooh, a tightrope. Okay, we got more monster guts. That's nice. Okay. Oh, watch the tightrope. Watch the tightrope. Alright, we can just drop down now. More monster guts. Okay. Got a rupee. Nice. Is that it? Okay. That leads over here. Oh, this is how we get to that treasure chest. Ah, I see you, game. I see you. Yeah, we needed to merge there. And we get a silver rupee. Nice, another 100, even though we kind of really did not need it since... Oh, and that's why that... I see you, game. I see you. Even though we don't really need that rupee. We did not really need it at all, to be honest, because we're sitting at over 3,000 right now. Although, like I did mention before, rupees are going to be very important at a later point. I wanted those monster guts. I am not sorry for grabbing those monster guts. Plus, we can just use the tornado rod and we're right back there anyway. But yeah, you're going to need a lot of rupees. Like I said, I'm probably going to off-screen some more grinding of rupees. There are mini-games that we can do, and if we're lucky, we can get rupees pretty easily, but I'm not lucky, I never have been. We can drop back down a floor if we head through that hole, but why would I? Ooh, that was a nice pot drop there. Right here, another tornado rod pot. Okay, I got hit. I got hit right there. That wasn't supposed to happen, but anyways... Do that here, break these. Oh, hit the switch, and that is going to drop a key. Now, future speedrunners, be advised, because you can actually do some type of speedrunning strat here. Ooh, nice, a red rupee. Alright, so, right here, stand a little bit above this platform. Normally, you would have to go around and merge and go on the tight walk thing to get the key, but... If you use the tornado rod and hold down, you can float in midair and grab the key. It's a nice little shortcut, I guess you could say. I don't know. I don't think you'd be able to classify that as a shortcut. Anyway, in this room, what is there? More rupees. Right there, I don't think... Yeah, we can't do anything right here. So we need to go out this way. That's another way to get... this fan right here will allow us to go up another level. But what we need to do is head down here. So... No, we don't want this one. I think it's this one? No, it is not. I messed that up. We need to pull this one. And that spawns a big chest. Okay. Okay, destroy these guys. Nice. Destroy the fire. Open the big chest. Get the big key. Excellent. Oh, and now we have these guys blocking the exit that way. Okay. I see you. Alright. Destroy the fire. Disperse the fire, I should say. And head here. Yeah, we can use the small key right here. Why not? And that's the other side here. Nice. Okay. So, doing this. We have our Kelpie friends. I know some enemy names, but some others I'm really bad at. So, ignore me if I try to say an enemy name and get it wrong. Just ignore me. Anyway, pulling this one here will allow this platform to go back and forth. Part of another tornado rod puzzle. Aw, oh, just barely didn't make it on. You need to use the tornado rod. Oh, we actually made it. Good. And we need to pull this, I believe? No, okay. Yeah, that ring of fire over there is what was important. So, over here, against the wall, near this key door, you merge, and look at that, there's a button. You press on it, and the key spawns in the middle of that ring of fire. The ring of fire? The ring of fire. Let's disperse that. Grab the key really quickly. Okay. And now let's make our way back over here. Oh, perfect. The tornado rod platform was like right there coming our way. And now it is mid-boss time. I don't know what you call these guys, but they take 6 hits to defeat. Oh, almost had him spawn... redo his one thing. There we go. Took him out. Alright, halfway point. Teleporter if we need it, but I really don't. So, let's make our way over here. Go down this way. And through this room. And now another wind puzzle. So, press this switch. Press this switch. Press this one, and head here. Excellent. Okay, Keys, you need to knock it off, Keys. Okay, hit this switch, turn off those fans. Okay, now let's head back this way. Up these stairs. Now we can drop down, and go this way. This was blocked off by these fans, but now, we can just head over here. Okay, and there's this... Well, first off, there's this keys. We can't hit that quite yet. Let's just take out this Igor, I believe is what your name is, right? Yeah, I think you're Igor. There we go. Hit that. And another, even bigger tornado rod, platform. Alright. Let's use that. Got it. Hit that. And activate that fan. So now we can go on to the next floor. Oh, that Keys, he was... Oh, well, he got me because I went back for him. Of course. Karma had to bite me. Alright, ooh, treasure chest right there. But we can't really grab that right now. Rat, get out of here. Okay. 5 rupees, I'll take it. Alright, let's head through here. Another lantern puzzle. That allows us to access the room to the left. Really? Did I get that third hit? I don't know if I did. And also, oh, I did grab it. Okay. That also, blew out the torch. You'd think realistically that that would mark that room off, but of course, thank goodness that it doesn't. Okay. Now we have these bubbles again. Okay. What we need to do is we basically need to get them to drop into the pit. Or, you know, just take them out with our sword. Whatever works, honestly. Okay, this is not going too well. Alright, we got that one. Just take it out with our sword, why not? A treasure chest is gonna appear up there. So we need to go around for that. So, let's make our way here. Okay. We need to merge along the wall here. In order to access this side. That's scary. That's really scary, the spark enemies. Okay. take you out, grab some hearts, grab this treasure chest, which is another small key. Okay. Now, we make our way back through here. Merge. There we go. Head through the door. Go back through here first and foremost. And then grab this 50 rupees thanks to the purple rupee. Excellent. Alright, let's light that just to be consistent. Open this locked door. And now there's one more tornado rod puzzle before we head to the boss. Time it carefully with using this. Oh, and of course the spark enemy would do this to me. Alright. Oh! I hate. Well, it looks like I'm going around again, but it's not a big deal. I wanted the money. I'm sorry. I'm very selfish and need money all the time. I'm just kidding. All right. Well, here we go. Let's wait. 3, 2, 1. Got it. And now let us face off against the boss. Say hello to Margo Mill! Alright. What you need to do is you need to use the tornado rod. There are 3 stages to this boss. The first stage is very easy. Just use the tornado rod to stun him and slice him with your sword. Now, this is where things are gonna get a little tricky. He basically towers up, and you need to take out the layers of his tower one by one in order to be able to hit him again. Now, there are points in this battle where you get stuck like that and chained with hits by his tower, and that will most likely cause you to go off the edge, but if you're careful, you can easily avoid it. Alright, there's the second phase of the fight down, and now the third phase is gonna grow even larger, so more towers to take down. Shouldn't be too bad, though. As long as we actually are able to hit him. There we go. That's 1 of 4. There we go. There we go. That one was easier this time. Alright. Halfway done. There we go. 1 more to go. Oh, we got chained. Alright, that's fine. That's fine. We have more than enough hearts in order to survive. Although I do hate getting chained because you just aren't able to hit at all. It's really bad. But with that, we have taken down Margo Mill. And here is our next heart container. As well as the Pendant of Wisdom. Gotta keep your mind sharp.
Weather today, so I swam here with the queen, but she swims so fast and I got left behind. I'm hurt, to be honest. The queen left me behind. I feel abandoned.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Zora Underling, but next time on The Legend of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds, we will make our way around Hyrule once more for a bit more side questing before we take on the final dungeon in Hyrule, thus earning the final Pendant of Virtue, the Pendant of Power. So with that, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.